Good morning, everyone. Today is Saturday, May 14th, and I'm here at the Mickey and Minnie Friends parking structure, which I don't think I've actually been at, because every time I've been here, we've found other alternative parking methods, but figured I'd try this one today. It's 30 bucks to park, and they have, like, parking systems the same way they do at World. Efficient, makes sense. And yeah, I'm here at 7:30. Took a little bit of time to get through the parking ramp to park, and now I'm just walking to the parks. Very excited for today. We'll see how nuts it is. It already sounds nuts, so I should go this way, actually. All right. I might be in the Pixar. I think I'm in the Inside Out parking, actually. Oh, that's the security line. Hi, Ball. All right, so passing through the security gates, they then put us into like this room that has like a tram. So I guess that's like an extension of the parking garage, but it's just super strange. Hello. Okay, because I'm a huge sucker, I did upgrade my ticket so that I can go park hopping, so I can go see World of Color. But I got a different ticket. Last time I got like a Rise of Resistance themed one, and now I have, this is Main Street Electrical Parade. I don't really know it. We're gonna explore today. And I'm very thrilled to be back. There's DCA, we'll head over there in a little bit, but I'm gonna try to get into Disneyland first so that I can start thinking of doing Disney Genie Plus. Might as well just try it and see how it goes, right? We'll see. Hello, good morning. This is so great. We are excited to be here. Is that right, Rink? Yes. Very excited. Hi, Disneyland. Hey, Matterhorn. Wow, it's been like a year since I've been back here. Wow, less than a year. There's Astro Orbiter. Man, this park is so small. This main area is tiny. I think they're queuing us all here before we all mad dash someplace else. I'm gonna try to hit Rise early. Sun's really low. It's 7:57, so I think everyone's stuck here on main area before they release us and the mad dash to Rise begins. So I got in right about the right time. I drove and got here around 7:12, got out of the parking structure at 7:30, got dropped off. I had to stop at the ticket booth to upgrade my park ticket, and I walked down Main Street, and I bought Disney Plus, or Genie Plus, and I already have my Hyperspace Mountain window booked, so excited for that. It's Hyperspace Mountain, Hyperspace Mountain, hype, 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 hype. Say hi, Rach. We're going. Should I go around? Nah, I'll follow the hordes. Good
time. Thank you.
Hello, Tom Sawyer Island. Are you any different from your other one? Although we did the canoes last time, and that was really fun. Why is Rise in the back of the park? I'm old. I don't know how to run to rope drop anymore. So I've blitzed like Adventureland and Frontierland, and now we are finally in Star Wars. App says 10 minutes for Rise. I am skeptical, but we shall see. And it's another instance of me going to the wrong, trying to predict the wrong side of the park where the end of the line is for Rise. I also have to use the bathroom, which is a big problem. I might try to come back. I don't know. We'll see. I don't need to do it.
Sorry.
I also don't need to wait in this line like this. So by the time I got to the back of the Rise line, so stupid. I don't know because I'm not a local, so I don't come here very often, but like, I don't know which side of the park to enter, which side of the land to enter. So I entered the side that's closer to Rise, not necessarily the side that's closest to, to the end of the queue, which obviously dynamically moves because the queue is always moving. It said it's over an hour, but I have Hyperspace Mountain at like 9:20, my latest to enter. So instead I'm gonna do Smuggler's Run and hope that it's super quick, because I actually think this one will be super quick because everybody's in line for Rise. That's a walk off.
Get out of here. Go. Nothing to see here. Get moving.
Oh, actually go?
Head on
inside. Okay, yeah.
Get out of here.
Which way? Right this way, my friend. That way. I don't know.
I, modest prophet, your god minus what you owe me for damaging the falcon is...
Ooh, we did not so great. We did okay. Oh, I killed 12.
I'm a scoundrel.
Very nice.
In the rank of scoundrel.
All right.
Nice.
Good team.
Go team.
So we finished Smuggler's Run. Pilots were not the best pilots, but it's okay. Piloting is really hard, but they like crashed into everything. It was kind of ridiculous. And the guy behind me, who was an engineer, I was gunner. I was trying manual control. I'll tell you about it in a second. But the guy in the behind was trying to give him tips, and it wasn't doing anything. Just because I think they were just kind of a disaster. Well, it's just hard because you only have one control axis. So for me, I was the gunner and I tried doing manual control, and you actually, like, I have to like hit different buttons to make things move. And it was a lot harder than I thought because the control isn't perfect. So you're just hitting buttons. It doesn't really tell you where exactly you're going or where exactly you're shooting or anything. So you just have to kind of guess and then adjust based on what you see on the screen. And if the pilots are just doing whatever, then you're crashing everything, and then it was just kind of a mess. But it was fun. Good way to wake up. Good way to get one done. But then I saw that Big Thunder Mountain is 5 minutes standby time. And it's literally, I am walking on right now. Just walking right up to the queues. It's great. I forgot how long the Disneyland Big Thunder Mountain is. It has three inclines, like parts where they take you up. It was literally a walk-on, good time, great ride, would highly recommend, especially if it's only 5 minutes.
I'm in Tomorrowland, and there is Hyperspace Mountain. I am so excited. It's been like 4 different parks, and this is the first one that has a Hyperspace Mountain that is open while I am here, yay! Oh, also, there's a Mandalorian spot. Photo spot? Fascinating. I'll have to look for that later. But yay, Hyperspace Mountain. All right, so it's 8:50. I redeemed my first lightning lane. And then I got another one for Indiana Jones right after. Oh, so excited. Need to skip all the line. It's on the other side. Oh, still a line here. But I think much faster. So one thing I noticed immediately is that all these windows are closed. And the lights are red. Day 12, command monkey.
Pre-launch procedures, including stowing hats, glasses,
this is Star Wars theme.
Cargo pouch located directly in front of you.
Still the spaceport. This is the room where we got stuck in last time because the ride broke down.
Disneyland Space Mountain is a lot less rickety, and it's got some good turns, good twists, fantastic. The theming, oh, amazing. Starting from the beginning, I had this grin on my face, and I just could not stop. I highly encourage anybody to get it if you can. It is so fun. there's some things in there that just do such a good job, and I'm probably gonna do it again, maybe more than once. It's an hour away right now, so maybe I'll try it later. So good.
There's like no line for anything in this park other than Hyperspace Mountain, Rise of Resistance. I think Smuggler's Run now has a line, and yeah, and Indiana Jones. But otherwise, there's like, it's ridiculous. Everything is like a walk-on, and it's still 9:05. It's great. Hi, Buzz. I got your pin earlier today.
I didn't do too bad. I did a lot better than I thought. Not great, not the best, but you know. It took me a while to figure out how to play this version. But I figured it out. It's fun. My hand hurts though. Might have to come back to this later.
Since there's no magic bands, everyone's doing it this way and sending it to themselves. I gotta wait for a thing. Hi. Look, it's me. Man, that resolution sucks. Oh my god. They have lattos in a jar. Hi, Disneyland lattos. How are you? Are you angry? So in that store, they also have this. I did a pin trade and I got this pirate ship. I got it because I've never seen it before. On the back, it does say limited edition of 300. So, grand opening of Shanghai Disney Resort. So it's probably their Pirates of the Caribbean, which I have ridden. It's kind of cool. It's a good trade, I think. They also had another Buzz pin in there, like one that I traded for earlier, so I feel less accomplished with that pin trade. Right across from Astro Blaster is Star Tours, and it's also 5 minutes, so I'm just gonna do it. I'm taking this walk a little bit less, have a little bit more fun kind of approach. I like Star Tours. So I feel like I haven't seen Vinyl Nations in so long. Also, that Ray Vinylmation looks terrifying. Absolutely terrifying. Star Tours is fine. It's one I've seen before, so I was kind of like, oh, it's okay. Woohoo! I have left Tomorrowland, now in Adventureland. I have a lightning lane for Indiana Jones, which is, I think, like the dinosaur track coaster. Oh, good thing I have one, because now it's 45 minutes. It's 9:42 and the park is starting to like wake up, so there's like a lot more people now. Yeah, it's getting a little busier, getting a little hotter, so that's also kind of a bummer. No clouds in the sky again like yesterday. It's gonna be a hot one. I'm already scoping out my nap times.
We're on Indiana Jones.
I much prefer the ride theming here than I do the dinosaur one at World. The dinosaur one at World just feels like fire and brimstone, everyone's gonna die. This one at least feels like an adventure, and so I really do appreciate the theming that goes into Indy. Yeah. It's a good one. Like, just jerked around a bunch. But it is pretty smooth, so I will give it that. Might come back, but I have a feeling this one's gonna get really busy as the day goes on. So, Jungle Cruise happens to be right next to Indiana Jones, and it says 40 minutes wait, which may be true. There's a bunch of lines, and they're loading people pretty quickly. There's just a lot of snaking and queuing, but she's like, it's covered, it's not so bad, I can take a break and chill for a little bit. I haven't done Jungle Cruise in a pretty long time, because every time at World, it's so long. And here, 40 minutes doesn't feel like the end of the world, you know what I mean? And there is no lightning lane for it. So, give it a shot. Alright, even though it said 40 minutes on the sign, it's only been like 20 minutes. So that's kind of cool. We're gonna get on the boat. Ah, Jungle Cruise. I haven't done this in so long. It's really hot. Here's our skipper.
And we're out of here.
She looks like 7 fun.
Around the world for being any point in time during our cruise, anything of value like your purse, your phone, your wallet, my tip, anything like that falls overboard, it's very important that you raise your hand, okay? That's going to indicate to me that I also need to raise my hand. And together, my friends, we're going to wave goodbye, okay? I can't get it out of the folding. Don't drop it. All right. Now, who's ready to see an animal? Woo!
So she had such high energy for a boat that was not reacting to her jokes whatsoever. I really appreciated that. I thought she did a really great job. So props to you, I think. Annalise, I'll have to go back and look at the name tag. But yeah, did a great job. Yeah, that was really fast. I was in and off in like 30 minutes. So the 40 is not right. Good for me.
I don't know how long it's gonna be for the train, but I'll hang out for a little bit. I can chill. And yeah, just enjoy. Hello, Disneyland Railroad.
Your attention, please.
Original ride has park opened.
Now leaving for a complete trip around Walt Disney's Magic Kingdom.
I forgot that Twin Town was even in Disneyland. Good time.
Please stay fully seated to the train.
All the people for Autopia. I don't get Autopia. Whoa. On the railroad. This is part of the railroad attraction. It's like a long tunnel where they show you things. Especially the Grand Canyon. Main Street Station, and you can see California Adventure on the other side on the front gates. This is cool. I've never done this before.
So the railroad was really nice. Nice to sit for a while and chill. There's a lot of like really interesting dioramas that I've never seen before, so I am actually quite fascinated that they existed. I do have a lightning lane for Smuggler's Run, so I'm gonna go back, see if I can get a better score. It was really funny, I didn't say this earlier, but the pilots before us, in front of us, they actually got negative credits. They got a negative score because they hit so many things. It was kind of sad. So hopefully this next one that I do will be a little bit better. It's also like a 45-minute wait on the app, so I am very thankful that I got that lightning lane.
There's Pooh and Tigger. Hi, Pooh and Tigger. Wait, who's that supposed to be? There's Chewbacca, but who's the other guy supposed to be? Oh no, he's wearing a regular tag. Funny. It's maintenance tech. Hi R2! It's R2! It's just hanging. Hi! Oh, that's a good idea. You can do it. We believe in you. Thanks for all you do.
Back in line for Smuggler's Run.
Pass the engine repair site.
Much faster.
Hi.
It's gonna be good. It's getting really hot. Air conditioning in here is a choice. I'm getting ready for lunch, so I'm excited. I'm thinking about it, so that's good. Yeah, it's really busy right now. I am impressed. Good job, California. We're gonna show up.
Pilots, line up behind the train. And engineers, you harpoon that precious cargo. Move out, my friends. See you in the cockpit.
Let's go.
Ah, then it is. Now, after my modest profit, your cut minus what you owe me for damaging the Falcon is.
Uh-oh.
Hey, not bad.
Not terrible. Hey, I kept the plane from dying. Marauder. Yay. I didn't reel. That was bad.
Wow.
Damage report. Engine failure. All right.
Oops.
So that was fun. Everyone in the car had fun, or in the ship had fun. I apparently didn't do my job well enough because I was trying to wait for my thing to line up, and it didn't line up. And when it did, I hit the button, and nothing happened. So we must have been too late. I don't know. Oh well. They do an I feel like every time I see something, I'm just like, hit the buttons because they're flashing. But I really should just take my time because that's. Yeah, I don't know. I want to do better, but I also don't want to wait in line anymore.
So I hopped into a shop and I found this Bina's Guide to the Creatures of Batu, and apparently inside there's all these different creatures that you can find. And so this is pretty much like Wilderness Explorer, and like they're all around the area. So you go find them and then you get a stamp. And this is amazing because I don't think Matthias has ever seen this, and I think he would love doing this. I'm so excited to do this entire activity book. Here's the log cat. And I found him. Look how cute he is. He's in the back. He's sleeping. Cute little guy. But yeah, he's got four claws. Okay, I'm gonna stop like showing you all the answers. But I'm gonna try to see if I can get a stamp.
Alright, so I just finished the booklet and I definitely did some things wrong, but I got some stamps anyway because the cast member did not care. I also missed the World of Color virtual queue by 5 minutes, and I'm really sad that I failed miserably on that because I pride myself on being punctual, but the alarm that I'd set for myself, I set it for the wrong day. It was for tomorrow. Put an F in the chat. Thank you. I'm actually headed to lunch now, Riverbell Terrace, so this will be my first time, and I am very much looking forward to it. Alright, so I've heard that if you sit inside, it's really loud, and it is kind of loud, but it's not super bad. I am in the corner, which is nice. Here's the menu. It's pretty standard stuff. I am not sure what to get, so I think I'm going to ask for recommendations. But it's a pretty simple menu. It's huge on the back. But yeah, I am looking forward to eating. I could eat, there's a patio, and I could maybe have asked to sit out there, but it's so hot, I'm very happy to sit inside. Okay, so I'm starting with the appetizer. This is loaded bites. It's tater tots with like brisket and pimento cheese, and a bunch of this pickled garbage that I don't like, so I'm gonna shove it to the side. But I'm very excited, it looks so good. A few bites in, and it's basically bar food, but the pickled onions are actually like making a really nice cut, and it's a little spicy, which is nice. I think these are like fried jalapenos, and yeah, the cheese is nice and tasty. I don't like pickles, so I stuck those to the side. But otherwise, everything tastes great. So here at Riverbell Terrace, I had gone to the bathroom to wash my hands, and it's like outside, so I had to like walk outside and come back. But when I came back, there's a couple sitting at that table right over there. and they told me that there was a kid sitting at the table in front of me, like right there, who like threw up all over the ground, and they wanted to move because they said, oh, we just don't want to sit, we don't want to eat around here. And I was like, I don't care, because one, I can't see it because the table is like blocking the view, which is good. The other thing is, I also didn't see the kid throw up, so I don't know how gross and unappetizing that was to me. But they ended up going to sit outside because that's the only place they can get a table, and I don't want to eat hot food outside right now. It's actually not terrible. Maybe I'm getting used to it, but it's not the heat of the day yet. It's still only 1 o'clock. Getting there though.
I destroyed that, and it is so good. Basically pub food. Brisket was definitely a highlight. The pimento cheese was very good. I have a light level of spice in my mouth, which is really nice. There's already a party sitting at that table. I don't know if anybody told them. I'm certainly not going to say a single word. So here's my cubano. It doesn't look like it has pickles, so thank goodness. And then here's a mojo, which is a dip for the cubano. I don't think I've ever had a cubano that looks like this. Usually the only one I've ever had is the one from work. So this is gonna be much better. All right, so I'm eating the cubano. The bread is actually quite good. It has like the texture of a baguette, but it's not a baguette. But it's very crispy, but still like eatable. The meat inside tastes good. The cheese is good. The ham is good. The sauce, but it's like very one note flavor, like lots of meat. The sauce has a little bit of like sour notes to it, which does complement this very well. So I am impressed. I think I might not use the sauce every time, but I'll use it for a lot of the sandwich. But it's pretty good. I would recommend this to many people, not to everybody. I don't think my mom would like it because I think it's just too much meat, but it does taste pretty good. So I'm looking forward to finishing it off.
Obviously left River Bell Terrace. Great experience. Nice, chill meal. I didn't feel pressured to like go quickly, even though I need to get over to DCA. I thought it was fun. You know, sometimes with characters I feel a little awkward because like human interaction. But my server was really cool and really didn't really make me, you know, feel guilty for requesting no pickles on my Cuban or anything. Anyway, I'm outside. It's hot. It's like 90 degrees now. Stepped outside and I was like, oof, the heat hit me. I will be sure to hydrate.
Yay, I jumped over to DCA. I wasn't expecting to come here today. I thought about it when I bought the ticket, but it's a very expensive ticket, so better make the best use of it. Fortunately, the Genie Plus works on both sides, and there's like, I'm able to get a lot of lightning lanes, so it's actually, I think, gonna work out, and actually, I think, be worth it to spend the extra $20. I'll reserve judgment for that when I finish, but yeah, gonna keep going. Oh, there's little Woody's! Hi, Woody. Oh, I might have to. Oh, I don't need more stuff.
They did better. Mucho sadness for me.
It's hard with one person. You can't unlock any of the bonuses.
And we keep getting stuck. Like, we keep stopping. Fascinating.
So at the exit of the queue, they have this little, like, I don't know, it's like a display. They've got, like, the little box there. Just kind of cool. Like, kind of helps with the theming, and Bo Peep's hat there. It's playing in the middle of the living room. And then it opens up to the shop, of course. I didn't realize, but over in this corner of this shop, near Pixar Pier, there's an artist doing things. He's using...
Oh, there is. I took some last night.
Super cool. Alright, here I am in Cars Land. I looked at some of the rides, but their time estimates, there's are no way correct. Because there's no way I'm going to wait. Like, I said 5 minutes and there's like 200 people, no way. But yeah, just walking around Cars Land. I know Cars Land is cooler at night, I'm going to enjoy here while I can. Ooh, photo pass. I'm going to do photo pass.
Just had a really nice photo pass session with a photographer named Jim, who he saw I was holding Rinky and he helped, like, you know, put him in different little configurations, and we took lots of pictures around Cars Land, which is really cool. I'm in a shop right now called Surgeon Surplus. I mostly came in here because I don't think I've ever been in the shop to see the merchandise. But also, in here, there's a replica of Cars Land, which is pretty darn cool, if you ask me. You even got all the little cars, and yeah, it looks awesome. I don't think I've ever seen that. I don't think I knew it was here. Maybe I did. I think I've seen it before. I've seen the movie. I did some pin trading. I found a Jabba the Hutt, so that's fun. I talked to the cast, one of the cast members there, and he was just telling me that it's like, one of our cast members used to be an Ewok in the movies, and I was like, that's fun. But then I think he got really bored with me. He looked like he was about to fall asleep. So I don't know if he just ate lunch or if I'm just really bored. You decide.
So I'm in the Starbucks getting the Been There series mug for Tiff. There's a poor soul who's just chilling. Such a mood.
So I was here and I got some Starbucks. One of the mugs that I had picked up was cracked, so I went and got replacement ones. And while I was in the line, I got to chatting with the lady next to me. Her name's Cynthia, and she was absolutely delightful. And we were just telling stories about, you know, our families, what we like about Disney, traveling, and all that stuff. And it was just a treat. Thank you. I wish her the best, and maybe I'll see her around. But I'm gonna keep wandering. She's gonna sit in the Starbucks, and I don't need to do that, but I don't know. I feel like if I sit in a Starbucks, I'm gonna fall asleep like that one lady. mood. But yeah, it is about 3 o'clock now, and it is pretty hot. It is the hottest. It's fantastic. So happy. So happy I'm here.
Photo pass.
Five and Dime just finished behind us, and I love that kind of somewhat random impromptu streetmosphere. I think it really separates, like, Disney from some of the other parks. Thinking mostly Valley Fair myself, but even like Knott's. Like Knott's, the one of the coolest things I thought they had was that piano that the guy was bicycling through the park. It's like something random. It's charming. It's cute, and it really elevates the experience, so you don't feel like you have to do rides all the time. So yeah, it was really nice. I'm gonna try to go PhilharMagic because it's 3:30 and I'm melting to death. Melting. My legs are puddles right now.
It is so cool in here with the air conditioning. Everybody is fading, I can tell. The PhilharMagic is always a solid bet, just because I could take a nap and it was air conditioned, it was lovely. There is an Avengers Superstore here. I don't know what's in here, but I'm going to go check it out. Thank goodness it is air conditioned in here as well. You know, if you have a spare $8,000, you can get a Mark III Iron Man costume. I don't know if you can put it on. I don't think so. It's a pretty big store. It reminds me of, like, the expos at the Run Disney stuff. Lots of, yeah, just general Marvel merch. Even the Marvel merch that's, like, not related to the movies. Because that doesn't even look like Mars and Cyclops. I guess that is a Thanos. Interesting. Oh, that Doctor Strange actually doesn't look too bad. interesting. Oh man, that really looks like him. The Tom Holland. Fascinating. There's Pingo Doce drink, whatever that is. Ooh, Avengers logo over there. That's kind of cool. I'm in this art store, and this one looks pretty cool. So my favorite thing of DCA, Animation Academy is closed. But this room is really chilly, and there's, you can see people are just lounging because it's so hot outside. And this song from Lilo and Stitch is just such a mood right now. I'm enjoying it. The Hyperion is also closed, so nothing's showing there either. That way is, I think, the Mike and Sully ride, which I will do later. But I think right now I have a fast pass, or lightning lane, for Mission Breakout.
Dad, let's mute this guy! Hearing your incessant swaggering on a constant loop was big motivation for me to escape. I go, ouch! Ow! That was not part of the plan!
Don't go anywhere.
Uh-oh.
She's apparently ridden it a million times, so she's an expert.
The Guardians Tower is very good. Nothing is ever as you expect, which is what makes it super duper fun. And my car was amazing. Everybody was just laughing, cheering. It was such a good time. It was just a really good car. It was so good. Yeah.
We screamed. It was good. Very nice. Haha, I get a kick out of this. Look at that statue. Interesting track. Talks. Yeah, so this is the Doctor Strange, like, sucked into reality spot that wasn't here last time Josh and Jens and I were here. So, finally got it. This Doctor Strange show is finishing, but it's so hot. I don't know why people are over there. I'm trying as hard as I can to not die. but yeah, just strolling through Avengers Campus. Thinking about doing Web Slingers. They said it's only 40 minutes, but I don't really like the ride that much, so I don't know if I will. I just like hearing the music. Music is great. I am doing a quick scan of World of Disney. Just looking mostly for Metal Earths, but just gonna see if there's other things that are cool. One thing I did see is they have new Kermit new emos, which is kind of fun if you like the Muppets. Oh wow, that's a lot of Turning Red merch. That's a lot of Turning Red merch. I don't get it. I don't want to hug a 13-year-old girl, even if she is a panda. This is strange. Alright, so I asked the cast members specifically about magnets, and this is, like, the only one they had in the store, and they said, yeah, we don't have very many. They had another one that I didn't like, but this one is kind of interesting just because everything rotates. Reminded me of Sherry, because she likes rotating things. The only thing about this one is that the construction is not very good. Like, there were ones in the displays where, like, this magnetic part was coming off. And, like, they have, like, where it was manufactured from. And, I don't know, it just doesn't feel like the highest quality magnet. So I'm hoping that it survives the trip back home. But anyway, that was my World of Disney trip. No Metal Earths, which is fine. I have enough of a backlog to build. Heading back into the park. Probably going to Disneyland, not DCA. And just like that, back into Disneyland. One thing I did miss was Dapper Dans. Oh, sad day. No Dapper Dans. So over here in this area of Frontierland, on these benches, there's a bunch of I think these are civilian pin traders. So they're not Disney guests. They're just people. Or sorry, they're not cast members. They're just guests. Fascinating. I am too nervous to actually talk to them because that's awkward for me. But, good for them. I'm glad he's not bored.
Okay. I just finished Big Thunder Mountain using the lightning lane, which is great. But I have a dilemma. I am starting to see a lot of people wearing like t-shirts that say like Spring Valley Senior Night, and like there's buttons everywhere that say grad night on them, and I'm a little concerned that it's going to be really busy all like into the evening hours and into like the night hours, like 10, 11, 12, because young people are here. Oh no, how am I going to ride Hyperspace Mountain 5 more times? How is it possible? Probably not, because it's like an hour and 10 minute wait, and I've already used my fast pass for that one. So it's starting to cool down, so that's a plus. It's also 6:50. It was like 90 degrees until like 6:30. I love the cast members because they're just so willing to share knowledge and information. They were saying, you know, I mean, you can also see people are starting to sit and stake out their seats for a parade that doesn't start for another 2 hours. 2 hours. I've got stuff to do, so I'm not gonna do that. And she said, you know, if you wait till 10:45, the second parade, then it's better. So I'm like, okay, I'm gonna wait for that. Which is a good advice. So that lets me, you know, continue to do stuff, because I'm gonna.
Lightning Lane for Small World still has a line. Wonderful. Small World. I like the Disneyland one better. But I haven't done it in years, so I'm hoping this one will be good. A bear. Is that Duffy? What? Found Alice and the Rabbit. And then Peter and Tinker up there. This one's so much better. So this room has like a bunch of different cultures. There's India, but China's right here, and I think that's Mushu. I think. Not gonna comment. It's Simba, Timon, and Pumbaa. Timon's just hiding the hang on the back. It took me a second. They look very different. Hi, Alice. Tres Caballeros. Listen to that guitar line.
So I'm not hungry, and the weather is cooling down. The sun is not beating on me anymore. So I'm gonna bite the bullet, and I'm gonna wait 85 minutes for Rise of the Resistance. Mostly because I don't really have that much else to do at the moment. One, and two, it gives me an opportunity to catch up on my mobile games.
55 minutes in the queue, and we are, you know, at interesting stuff. I guess technically still in the queue, but at least there's pre-show. Woohoo! 55! Not bad. Not 85, and not in the sun. Also, there are a lot of benches along the way, which is nice. The moon is particularly bright today, but because we're, you know, in Star Wars, it's not a moon. One. Thank you.
Wait, you still here?
All right, 55 minutes till when we got to the queue that was cool, part of the queue that was cool, and 75 minutes to when we were off of the ride. Pretty good, not terrible. I might do it again. It's so good. I mean, probably not tonight, but I would probably wait. My only thing is, like, right now it's 9 o'clock, so I mean, I waited till like the end of the night to do it because it's just too much stuff going on. But yeah, so I think I'm gonna head to the front of the park, try to get to the Starbucks. I don't know, just go head to the front. It'll be more chill, hopefully. Probably won't be. It might be insane. We shall see. The moon is very nice tonight. It's like a full, or pretty close at least. Alright, so I took the wrong turn multiple times after Rise. I'm trying to get to Main Street, but because of the fireworks, they're blocking everybody off. So it's a huge cluster. So now I'm just going through Tomorrowland to get all the way around. Mind you, I was in Frontierland, which means I've literally circumvented the entire park on the backside trying to get to the front so I can watch the next show. Oops!
So I got here 2 minutes before the fireworks started. I can see the castle there. Someone put a tree in the way, but at least I'll be able to see the fireworks. So that's fun. So I think I saw Mickey's Mixed Magic last time. This is Disneyland Forever. So I think it'll be a different show than what I saw last time, which is a good thing. I'm excited. We're past time, so we should be starting soon. Is very annoying. Slide.
back here, it is amazing. Bye, Nemo. Oh, it's on a thing. It's on a wire. Oh no! Oh wait, tail flaps. That's impressive. And then Frozen, of course.
Alright, so the show just finished. It was different than Mickey's Mouse Dance Party. So this one was like the Disneyland Forever. That's what it's called. And so the idea of Disneyland Forever is that, I don't know, it's good. I liked it. I don't think it's very similar in the feel of like Wishes and Harmonious and the new one, that Enchantment. So they're all just kind of the same kind of vein, but it was fun. I really enjoyed the little things that are floating around. I did not expect to see those, because it was more than just the one zip line. They were going back and forth, which is really cool. The tree in the way was kind of annoying, but at some point you just kind of shrug your shoulders and say, I didn't sit here for 2 hours, so I'm going to get kind of a crappy spot. Music was good. Good stuff. All right. There's still like two more hours to this night, so we've got stuff to do. Let's get going.
I'm at the Starbucks, got the Disneyland mugs, and I also got a frap. I think that's mine. Nope, not me. Two for Nayeli, not me. I was gonna say Nate, but that looks like mine actually. Yes. That's me. Thank you. Oh, yes. Thanks.
Nayeli?
Oh, it even has... Cute.
I don't do sugary stuff or sugary drinks. I'd rather eat sugary foods. But I haven't eaten dinner because of what I ate for lunch. And I just want ice cream, which is basically what this is.
The parade is starting! Yay! Oh, Goofy's driving! Hi, Goofy! And then Mickey's up top, but he's hard to see. Hi, Mickey. I don't know why this lady keeps using Flash next to me. So fun!
You did good!
Those poor cast members having to hold it up. Sisters.
That's right.
watches. Also, oh, this is super cool. Mowgli. Oh, Raya in the back. It's a small world. That's the end of the parade. Woo! Pull it back.
Hoping to finish the night off with one last coaster. It says 60 minutes. I kind of doubt it'll be that long, but we shall see. It could be. No idea. I didn't do the normal queue last time, so. Could be.
I'm almost there. I'm almost there. There's the line. I'm so excited, but I'm also so tired. Gonna make it. It's gonna be good.
That was amazing.
So good the second time still. The ride is just so much better. Like, it's so much smoother than Magic Kingdom. It's more comfortable. Everything about it is just so good. Glad I stayed and did it for the last thing I did. Alright, that's it. I'm heading out. Gonna head back to the parking structure. Park is closed. Can't do anything else. Except maybe shop, but I already did my shopping, so.
Space. Space. Yay, an empty Disneyland. Not insane. What a good day. But I am pretty tired. It's been a long day. We'll never get sick of the lights of Main Street. One of the most amazing things about Disney parks, the night of Main Street lights.